Let's say a prayer together. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we thank you for our school year that's just about over. We thank you for the fact that today, 1 week from today, we'll be looking at our last day of in-person schooling. We prove a lot of other places in this country wrong by being able to have school in the midst of the pandemic. Thank you for St. Paul, who came from Damascus to Damascus. Took you a while. Thank you for the talent in this room, for the kids that are here tonight. Bless them with a great summer, and bless our teachers with a restful summer. We say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Take it away.
All right, so this is the fifth grade, man. He's going to see the conquering hero come. This was written by Jordan Frederick Kendall. Mid-1700s, they did not have an ensemble like this back then, so this is adapted from an orchestral piece. So this is See the Conquering Hero Come. administrators, and they are playing a piece that is much more modern. This is written probably in the 80s. This is Rocco Poco.
Hello, hi, my name is Nancy Wortman. I am the preschool and junior kindergarten teacher at Holy Trinity, along with Christy Wentz as our teacher's assistant. This class is the morning preschoolers. They come Monday, Wednesday, Friday morning to school, and they are very excited to sing for you tonight, right?
Thank you. He healed the sick, he made blind and seen, he left the lame.
again, you can pick up the preschoolers. There is no daycare, so you need to pick up your preschoolers from the Learning Center at this time. Thank you.
Thank you.
one very traditional fashion, nice bow, very beautiful. The second one on each of them adds a little bit to it. You want to make it a rock song, adding some really fun rhythms, or just changing the style completely. So we have Amazing Grace and the Stalling Block.
Thank you. Thank you. so many of you here tonight. First of all, before we get this part of the third through sixth grade program started, we're going to dedicate this tonight to all of you who have ever served in the armed forces. We just don't thank you enough for what you do for our country. So would you please stand if you've ever served in the armed forces? This tonight to all those healthcare workers that have done such a great job taking care of us in such an awful time. So first responders, healthcare workers, nurses, anyone who works in the health field, would you please stand? And we thank you. It has been a difficult year, but these kids behind me, they've pushed through and they've done a great job. And we just really want to thank you for just supporting us in this time. And now we're going to perform for you, This Is America.
Thank you. be here now. We live in cities and we live in towns. We were born here, we came here. We have dark skin, we have light skin. We have our own opinions, and we speak them freely. We can worship as we wish.
They say we may protect and defend ourselves. They say no matter what our ethnic origins are, we are all equal, and we are all free. This is America, and we are Americans.
Citation of the Bible of the Star Spangled Banner. Thank you. a powerful nation. Even though America has only been a country since 1776, it's become one of the greatest countries that has ever existed. It's become a major world power.
The power of America comes from its people. The rights of the American people are guaranteed by the Bill of Rights and the Constitution of the United States.
In exchange for our rights, we Americans have responsibilities to our country. We abide by the rules or laws of our country.
We vote to choose our leaders. We pay taxes to support our government and the work that it does.
Some people serve in the Army, Navy, or Air Force in order to help protect our country. No matter how different we all are, we are united by our country, united by our freedom.
We are united when we work to solve common problems. We are united when we strive to reach common goals.
We are united when we fight common enemies. We are united when we defend our American way of life.
The strong are united. When it comes to our freedom, we are always united. That's why we are called the United States of America.
I've always been free. I've never known a slave. I've never known a dictator. I don't know what it feels like to be put into prison. I don't know what it feels like to fight in a civil war. I don't know what it's like to be whipped and have my family taken from me. I don't know how it feels to be put into prison for speaking my mind. I don't know how it feels to have a foreign soldier enter my home and take it from me. I don't know oppression and fear of my own government. I don't know always having to run away and be free.
I'll tell you what I mean. I know that I am blessed by the lives of freedom. I know that I am extremely lucky in America and living in the time I'm in this place. I know that I am really confident. I know I can dare to dream and know that my dreams can be realized. I know that I am allowed to have my own opinions without fear. I know that my voice is allowed to be heard.
I am free to be wealthy. I am free to have friends. I am free to have a home. I am free to have as much education as I want. I am free to pray and to choose. I am free to lead by example. Freedom shines on every American. That is what I know. I have always been free. And as long as I am American, I will always be free.
Mississippi. Missouri.
Montana.
Nebraska.
Nevada.
New Jersey.
New Mexico.
New York.
The lights of St. Vincent shining out in liberty. Bonnie Shaker of Portland, shine upon us as we stand free.
North Dakota.
Oklahoma.
Oregon.
Pennsylvania.
South Carolina.
South Dakota.
Tennessee.
Texas.
Utah.
Virginia.
Washington.
West Virginia.
Wisconsin.
Wyoming.
Thank you very, very much. Good job, guys. You did it. I just really want to thank everybody for coming tonight. And actually, we have to say goodbye to our sixth graders. This is their last concert, and they're so sad. But again, just thank you so much for everything you've done for us this year. We really appreciate it.
You never know when to do a standing ovation around here, so stand up and give them a clap, will ya? You know, after just sitting there listening to it, you know, it's just like we needed to have that balm on us this year, didn't we? It's been such a year for our country. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Have a good evening.
Before I go, the fifth graders made some rain sticks and squawking parrots, and you can look at those on the back tables, and we'll let third grade go first.
Don't forget the root beer floats outside in the hallway. Preferably eat them outside.